smiling down from the upper hall. She sees a bartender in a pool of blood. Cries out, my God, and kills them all.
Here comes the story of the hurricane. The man the authorities came to blame.
For something that he'll never do. Put in a prison cell, the one child he could have been. The champion of the world. Lighting at his patio seat. Another man named Bello moving about mysteriously. I didn't do what he says, and he throws up his hands. I was only robbing the register, I hope you understand.
I saw them leaving, he says, and he stops. One of us has better call up the cop.
There's some patty calls the cop, and they arrive on the scene with a red light flashing. And a half New Jersey night. Meanwhile, far away in another part of town, Reuben Carter and a couple of friends are just out driving around. Number one contender for the middleweight crown. Had no idea what kind of ship was about to go down.
So the cop pulled him over to the side of the road. Just like the time before, and the time before that.
In Patterson, that's just the way things go. If you're black, you might as well not show up on the street unless you wanna draw the heat. Now, the fellow had a partner, he had a rap for the cops. Him and Arthur Dexter Bradley were just out prowling around. Saw a couple of men running, they looked like middleweight. They jumped into a white car with out-of-state plates.
And Miss Patty Valentine just nodded her head.
The cops said, wait a minute, boys, this one's not dead. So they took him to the infirmary. And though this man could hardly see, they told him he could identify the guilty man. Reuben out. They take him to the hospital and they drag him upstairs. The wounded man looks up to his one dying eye, says, why'd you bring him here for, boys? He ain't the guy.
This is the story of the hurricane. The man the authorities came to blame.
Something that he never done. But in a prison cell, the one child he could have been. The champion of the world. Months later and the kettles are in flames. Reuben's in South America fighting for his name. Well, Arthur Dexter Bradley still in the robbery game. And the cops are putting the screws to him looking for somebody to blame.
Remember that murder that happened in the bar? Remember how you said you saw the getaway car?
Well, thinking like to play ball for the law. Think it might have been that fighter that you saw running in the night. Don't forget that you are white. Hey. Oh. When Arthur Dexter Bradley said, I'm really not sure. The cops said a poor boy like you could use a break. Got you for the motel job and we're talking to your friend Bello. You don't wanna have to go back to jail, so be a nice fellow.
And you'll be doing society a favor. That son of a bitch is brave and getting braver.
We wanna put his ass in stir. We wanna pin this triple murder on him. He ain't no gentleman jail. Could take a man out with just one punch, but he never did like to talk about it all that much. It's my work, you'd say, and I do it for pay.
And when it's over, I'd just as soon be on my way up to some paradise where the drops keep flowing, the air is nice. And ride a horse along a trail, but then they took him to the jailhouse where they tried to turn a man into a mouse. Oh, oh. All the Rubens cards were marked in advance. The trial was a big circus, he never had a chance. The judge made Rubens witnesses, our drunkards from the slums. And to the white folks who watched, he was a revolutionary bomb. And to the black folks, he was just a crazy nigger. No one doubted that he pulled the trigger. And though they could not produce the gun, the DA said it was the one who did the deed. And the all-white jury agreed. Reuben Carter was forced to try. The crime was murder one, and guess who testified? Bello and Bradley, and they both boldly lied. And the newspapers, they all went along for the ride. How can the life of such a man be in the palm of some fool's hand? To see him obviously framed, I couldn't help but make me feel ashamed to live in a land. But justice is a game. Oh. All the criminals in their coats and their ties are free to drink martinis and watch the sunrise. While Ruben sits like Buddha in a 10-foot cell, an innocent man in a living hell. That was the story of the hurricane, but it won't be over till they prove his name. And give him back the time he's done, put in a prison cell, but